So with that, I request Kilona Behra to quickly run us through the platform which is which EnergyLess provided for conducting virtual AGM.
Yes, good evening everybody, and I would like to thank NISM as well as for that matter Nestle and even Hindustan Unilever for consenting to showcase the kind of support in terms of what NSEL has facilitated through the virtual AGM solution that we have provided. Today's contention of the topic would be on the service provider perspective. So with taking this further from what we have heard in the earlier two experiences, wherein we've had Nestle, which has already had a end-to-end one-stop solution which we have facilitated for the entire virtual AGM getting done, and the second option wherein we have had it with Hindustan Unilever. With both the companies, we have had a very close coordination done right from the time we had the test mock runs till the final day of the meeting, and we could see the success stories with these two companies actually having the kind of experience one would look at for the virtual AGM being done. Now, to go into directly the content of what we are wanting to showcase here is NSEL has been the leading service provider in this segment. This is equivalent to the similar kind of the leadership role play we have done it for the e-voting platform, wherein we have had it done in for the webcast platform, for the remote login, and as well as for the tablet-based voting. In case of virtual AGM, what we have been catering to is we have gone in for a one-stop solution for the entire set of events that we have. We've also facilitated for the companies all the requisite requirements in line with the MCA circular which came out in April 2020 and May 2020, so that it would cater to the compliance orientation aspect, as well as it would bridge the shareholder fraternity with that of the listed Indian companies who are looking at having their AGMs conducted in a virtual form, given the current pandemic situation that everybody was experiencing. It also gave a comfort level for the company secretaries in particular to get accustomed with the technology-driven processes, which were a very much important aspect. In this slide, which is being front showed to everybody, if you look at it, NSEL has been the one-stop solution for managing the entire events that we have of the virtual AGM. We have been given the facility of on a WebEx platform as well for the company, so that you know, if required in terms of the facilitation for making a user-friendly platform, a secure platform, and also to give the provisions for the physical shareholders to view the annual general meeting and new year GMs getting done in this virtual mode was very much feasible. The system also has a lot of insights in terms of giving the comfort level to the shareholders that if they are not able to actually visit the venue of the meeting, nevertheless, the comfort for participating in the voting period, if that is facilitated during the virtual AGM and in a secured manner, that also is being enhanced in terms of the OTP-based login as well as the SMS alerts for the voting which gets catered to. Now, an important aspect where we found a lot of companies were very much affirmative with the kind of solutions which NSEL had rolled out was also extending the facility of inspection of documents. In fact, Nestle was one of the first companies wherein they had required NSEL to facilitate that on the e-voting platform. Thereafter, all the companies who would look at getting the arrangement was also made available. Now, the key players in facilitating effective virtual AGM, when we look at it, then essentially, of course, it is the company, because the company will have to facilitate with the platform service provider as to which agency they are looking at. So in the case of Nestle or in the case of HUL also, it was decided that they would prefer going it with an experienced player like NSEL, since we had already, before even it could get mandated, we had showcased a success story for the two-way communication of live streaming when we had done it a couple of years back with L&T doing it with NSEL then, and also in terms of the webcast services engagement which we had facilitated. To give a comfort for the companies, we had also given the ability for giving a comfort level for the moderator, because he per se plays the bridging role between the company officials who are represented by the panelist team on the dais on a virtual AGM and the shareholder speakers who are coming in to join into the virtual AGM. Apart from this, it also gave an opportunity for the shareholder speakers to participate in the virtual AGM. So we had to give a very secured links for only such users who are going to come into the system with credentials being identified well in advance. And apart from this also, the comfort level was in terms of the company's engagement for the scrutinizer to get the reports in terms of the voting results during the meeting, as well as the voting participation which has happened 5 o'clock prior to the date of the meeting, a day prior, that also in a combined consolidated form, the reports were being made available as per the requirements. Now, if you look at the offerings that we have for maximizing shareholders' participation, this is of course just a rush through. In terms of e-voting, I think everybody is on this platform are very well acquainted with what we have in the offering. It's an SEQC certified platform, highly secured with the login credentials, as well as it gives the ability for a real-time basis participation for the stakeholders to watch and see the entire proceedings. Apart from that, if you look at it as a two-way communication, wider participation has definitely been enhanced. From the time the requirement for virtual AGM has been in place, we have seen almost around 32 listed companies who have come in and have availed the services. Out of these companies, the preference has strongly been with around 29 to 28 companies preferring it to NSEL and one or two companies going with the other service providers. But the majority endorsement has been considering NSEL, giving the ability that, you know, they have the comfort level, they have the technology-driven process and the comfort for the participants in terms of the panelists, the sectoral team, the moderator and the top management on coming in easily into the virtual AGM as well. As I would likely like to also reconnect with what Mr. Basin sir had said and also what Mr. Rai had suggested, they did have a lot of mock runs which were done. This gave a comfort level to the top management of the organization as well as for the team members that they were able to have a confidence that the virtual AGM is going to stay. We are also getting a lot of positive responses from many of the company secretaries that even after the situation improvises compared to the current pandemic situation, many of them would prefer to continue with a virtual AGM because it does have a lot of strong merits in terms of conducting it in a very easy manner. It definitely gives a lot of comfort for the company also in terms of the process improvisation, in terms of technology-driven processes and costing, which is effectively getting endorsed in terms of comparison to the actual AGM which gets done. The requisite requirements for the reporting and the recordings which are available of the entire virtual AGM is also shared by NSEL as per the requirements of the requisite company. Now, if you look at it in terms of the understanding for the participation of a shareholders, such shareholders who will be logging into the remote e-voting secured login credentials will be facilitated so that they can join into the meeting. The management also has a concern as to when you come into a virtual AGM, how is we have the ability to control the time which is assigned to the shareholder speaker. So that what we have seen in terms of the reiterations, in terms of what we have been endorsing with the shareholders also, the communication which goes from the company side to acknowledge the shareholder speakers who are getting registered for a virtual AGM, they have the basis in terms of how they are supposed to join into the system and how they are able to participate by posing their questions during the meeting on a concurrent basis if that is required. So in a nutshell, if we say that the solutions which NSEL has offered has definitely given the sequencing of the virtual AGM being done in the same manner as it would happen in a normal scenario. Now, from the perspective of what we have seen is for the comfort level for the companies, we had a couple of dry runs done. In some companies, it has gone up to even 5 or even 6 times. But the end result has been fantastic in seeing the participation of the shareholders. A few companies have had the participation coming on the virtual AGM as one as high as around close to 1300, which is a very encouraging figure. That means we know that the market has accepted this kind of a new norm and it is definitely going to be there to stay. From the shareholders' perspective, if you look at it, nothing has changed. They are already familiar with the e-voting platform that is there of NSEL. They would log into the system through the secured login credentials and they would accordingly have an ability to click on a relevant link against a particular ongoing AGM or general meeting of the company and watch the streaming live. For companies who come in the top 100, they also have the facilitation that the webcast requirement, which was stipulated by SEBI last April 1st to 2019, where it was mandated, that facilitation also is getting included in terms of the solutions which is being offered along with the virtual AGM that NSEL is providing for. Now, in terms of the ease, when you look at it from the company's perspective, that definitely has been catered to. From the shareholders' perspective, also that has been catered to. We have definitely seen in terms of the events which have taken place, I would just like to share with all. May 28, 2020, it was for the first time, if we look at it, for an unlisted company to conduct its general meeting through a virtual AGM mode, which was again done with NSEL as a service partner. And this was done by Anheuser-Busch InWave India Limited. we had Tata Consultancy Services being the first Indian listed company which conducted its AGM on 11th of June 2020. Then again, the preferred service partner being NACL. This was immediately followed by DIC India Limited, which happened to be the second listed company, but first from Kolkata, which preferred to again engage NACL as a service provider using the virtual solutions that we had offered for conducting the meeting. We have also seen not only in terms of the companies which were from the listed segment, even if you look at the nationalized banks and private sector banks, we've had seen companies showing interest and banks showing interest in this service as well. So if we see, State Bank of India actually turned out to be the first such public sector bank, which on 17th June 2020, they had conducted their general meeting using the same platform which NACL had provided for conducting the virtual AGM. Nestle India Limited has been the first company that we have, which has catered to availing the solutions from NACL. On 19th June 2020 from New Delhi, they had availed it. And apart from that, we've had a couple of other first names, if I would say, from Ahmedabad. We've had Adani Green Energy Limited, which did their AGM on 25th of June. That again was done with the NACL service provider platform. And as well as we had Infosys Limited from Bengaluru, which had done it on the 27th of June for the first company doing it from that sector, that region as well. Hindustan Unilever definitely stands out in terms of one of the largest, if I say, in terms of the MNC companies from Mumbai, which had looked at going in for a virtual AGM. They had recorded almost 39 shareholder speakers which had joined in, and that service solution again was catered through with NACL as a service partner. So if you put it across in terms of the preference choice, NACL has always been the preferred solution. This essentially has been because of the fact that if you take it in terms of group level, there are many companies, it be the entire Tata group of companies that we've had. It may be TCS, Tata Steel, Tata Motors, Tata Power, Indian Hotels, and many other such companies. If you look at in the banks, we've had a lot of banks who have definitely endorsed that they would prefer with NACL. It be HDFC Bank, you have Yes Bank, you have Kotak Mahindra Bank, ICICI Bank, and a couple of other banks. In the public sector also, there have been a lot of banks who have preferred to go ahead with NACL. IT majors, if you look at it, Infosys, as I said, TCS, as I said, these are few names to cite, Hexaware, etc. They have preferred NACL. And similarly, if you look at companies which also have been recognized with good compliance standards, many of the names that we have cited, including ACC, including HDFC Limited, and the other such companies, the preference has always been with the service provider, NACL, because of the fact that we have been in the industry for so long. We have been able to cater to the requirements of the companies in terms of the support, in terms of the reach out, as well as the trust that is built in. And most importantly, in terms of the technology-driven processes, if you look at it, yes, NACL is the name which has been able to be the preferred choice across all the service providers. I think what we have been able to talk in this entire session is the experience from the company's perspective, because they have actually even seen the solutions which have been offered by NACL. In terms of what we have catered to from NACL as a service provider, we have been very open and flexible to the customization of the corporate's needs. And on a pan-India level, the reach-out points, if you look at it, it has been very strongly seen in the northern region, whereas it is in the south, as well as in other places that we have in Bengaluru, in Hyderabad, Kolkata, Cochin, Ahmedabad, and other locations. NACL has set up a system in such a way that we have a 24/7 kind of a team, which every listed company has a dedicated relationship manager who is there right from the time of having the draft of the notice of the virtual AGM being prepared, to the mock dry runs getting done, to the actual events which take place, wherein we are deploying our own official also at the venue or at the place where the company would like to have the comfort of the moderator and the handholding for the virtual AGM being done. And most importantly, the entire proceedings of the meetings after it is concluded of the virtual AGM, we are facilitating that at the shortest possible time. I think the earliest that we've been able to give any company has been less than even 30 minutes. So this is a very encouraging figure. In terms of the costing also, many of the companies have definitely seen that the cost has drastically reduced to almost 1/10 of what it was in terms of the outflow had they gone in for an actual AGM being conducted. So this is with this, I think what we are trying to endorse is NACL definitely would be looking forward to facilitating any of the requirements that your office would be looking at. And most importantly, I think with this, we would like to thank also NISM, Dr. Narasimhan sir, and the entire team for giving NACL an opportunity to explain and give a insight into what we have as terms of the solutions for the entire team in the Capital Market fraternity. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Kiruna, for providing information about your NSDL's platform.